else you're talking about, animal food, it may not be here. It might have migrated away, or it might have hibernated. And then there's the question of energy expenditure. If you're out and about looking for food in icy conditions like this, you've got to heat yourself up, you've got to move about. That costs a lot of energy. You've got to make sure you're going to get it back when you find that food. There are some animals, however, that have come up with strategies that avoid this problem. Badgers are one of a group of animals which don't hibernate, but which take on extra fat reserves so they can afford to remain inactive when conditions are too tough for one searching for food. Now, this is a bit like coming home for me. I first crouched here in 1979, 13 years ago, when I began studying badgers here in the New Forest. They've been active. You can see that they've been out. They've shaken some soil off of their fur. There are a few footprints, but there are not a lot of signs of activity here. I wouldn't mind betting that this clan of badgers are going to stay down there, using up those fat reserves, until things get better out here. This is a spot that many people come to in the forest to feed the birds. And as you can see, there are plenty here today. Everyone benefits and gets super views of the birds themselves, and of course the birds benefit too. You can see there's a great range of species here. Nuthatch, blue tit, nice to see a few marsh tits too, grey tits as well of course, there are robins about, and greater spotted woodpeckers. What we've got here is a mixed species flock, and this is one of the strategies that woodland birds employ when food becomes scarce in the winter time. There are many advantages of flocking together. Firstly, more eyes to look for food, because time spent finding